better do your research. Feeling like I fell out of the sky and landed feet first. My squad go hard, my squad go country. Watch my team work.
Sometimes you gotta push through all your obstacles, man. There's no roof, there's no fall. Let's go. Seem like life go lighter speed. Slow it on down, baby, just to breathe. It's cold outside, adjust your sleeve. Got here late, like just to leave.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Friday Night SmackDown. We've come to fight on Friday nights. That's what we do. That's all we do on Friday nights. And here comes a man who, well, beat the crap out of Riley Sparks last week. Yeah! That's what the people want to see. The people want to see Riley Sparks getting his ass kicked. The Intercontinental Champion was very surprised last week by this gentleman right here who, well, has been missing for quite a while, for about like 2 weeks. That's still a long time in WWE time. He's been missing and, Well, he's back, and he last week came back with a huge impact and knocked the crap out of Riley Sparks and came out to save Daniel Bryan from an attack that was going to pretty much turn deadly by Riley's world on Daniel Bryan. But he came out and he saved him. You know, the lights went out. We were thinking Undertaker, Shield, who knows? And then he comes out and lays out the man known as Riley Sparks. And here comes a member of Riley's World, one half of the tag team champions, Rey Mysterio. Now, we're still trying to figure out why Rey turned his back on the fans since, well, WrestleMania. We're still trying to figure out why. There's really been no clear cut to why he's done it, except for him saying he wants to win gold. That's about it. But I'm just not believing that. I'm just not buying that. There has to be a specific reason why he's just turned his back on everyone. There has to be something going on here. I don't know what Riley's world has on him, but something's going on here. I don't know, man. Something weird and something crazy is going on here. But Rey is a half of the tag team champions with AJ Styles, and he's about to go one-on-one. Wait, what's going on here? What? Wait, you're a little family? Oh, you're a little family? That's what's going to happen? That's true. You had the life of having these fans love you and adore you. They once loved you. You were a superhero, but recently you respected you. You're a role model for... Oh, okay. Yeah, that's true. They are both are Latinos. Spanish... Oh, that is true, you know. No one... That's right, Riley Sparks is the biggest low-life cheater backstabber in the freaking world. And yes, he's a big-time D-bag. That's right. You did bring him to WWE, which is probably your worst mistake you've ever done. That's true. A lot of weeks ago, actually, a couple months ago, Juan, but it's okay. Ray found himself, baby. Nah, Juan found himself, apparently. Well, you want to run the show? You were on the world? Oh, you were already running the show, and now apparently you want to run the show. We've took you seriously, man. We always took you seriously. Yeah, you retired Booker T, and you... Wait, what? Woo! Rey Mysterio! You ran over my boy Teddy Long! That's why we haven't had a tag team match in so long! Rey Mysterio ran over Teddy Long! Oh, baby, here we go. Let's kick each other's teeth in. Oh, yeah. So, let me just clarify this again. We have finally found the man who has ran over Teddy Long. And it's none other than Rey Mysterio. Now, there's two things that are probably popping through your mind. Rey Mysterio can drive a car. And two, did they have to put phone books on the seat so he could reach the steering wheel? But Rey Mysterio, the man who apparently ran over our general manager, Teddy Long. I don't know, man. I don't believe this crap. Look at Rey Mysterio going right to work on Juan. These two guys are two very successful Latino superstars here in the WWE. They've tried to do whatever they can. They've gone before at it before in this ring. But tonight here on SmackDown, we're about to see these two guys go at it, but this time in different roles. Rey was always playing the role of the good guy. Now he's the guy playing the bad guy. And now we know why. We now know why Rey Mysterio has turned into a douche. You know, apparently Riley's World told him, run over Teddy Long. And we'll give you everything you want. We'll give you respect. We'll have people taking you seriously. We'll give you gold. We'll give you all this and that. The promises of Riley Sparks that have been given to Rey Mysterio for just doing that one deed, that one evil deed of running over our poor general manager Teddy Long, our innocent general manager. Teddy Long being ran over by a car at his age is not good for his health. That might just hurt him and might make him give us more tag team matches. That's not what everybody wants. What does everybody need? Tag team matches. What does everybody want? Tag team matches. And Rey Mysterio going high risk, but it's not going to work. It's not going to work. As Juan now goes to work. Here we go. Working on him, man. That's how you got to do it. Juan wants a chance at the Intercontinental Championship. You heard him earlier saying, you better tell Riley Sparks that I'm coming for that Intercontinental Championship. Your whole little world is going to come crashing down. And what about the announcement that our interim general manager will be back next week after his little suspension for what happened at NXT Redemption? He will be back, though. General manager Mr. Duncan will be back, and that's something we are very happy to hear. You know, the guy needs to come back so he can control what is going on here on SmackDown. And look at, oh, Rey Mysterio again. Rey with the frog splash. And Juan now going back to work. It's good to see him back in that ring. Good to see him coming back. Remember, he was offered a chance to be part of Riley's World. He was a tag team partner with AJ Styles. That was his NXT rookie who won the NXT competition and had a chance at the tag team championships. Rey Mysterio missing that big time maneuver, and that's what you get. That's what you get. Juan's got a chair. It's not a, it's a, hey, if he hits him with that chair, it's going to be something special. And there it was. There it was. That's what we want to see. We want to see people get hit in the face with chairs. That's what I came here to see. Here comes the pinfall. Here we go. Oh, kick out. Wait, the roll-up by Rey Mysterio. Oh, my goodness gracious. No. Kick out. A kick out, though. A good kick out right there. Remember, Juan was offered a chance to be part of Riley's World alongside AJ Styles. AJ Styles took it. And, well, I think he would take it. See, I didn't think he would take it, but he took it. He took the chance to be part of their team. I didn't think AJ would do it, but he did it. And he left Juan, apparently, and now we have Rey Mysterio. And we're trying to figure out what happened to Juan. Apparently, he went to go find himself in the woods and, you know, and all that little jazz. He was wearing a black turtleneck, and, you know, he was thinking all this and that. But, you know, we were just thinking, what is going on here? And now he's back, and he, you know, he didn't. Good thing he didn't take the side of Riley's World. Good thing he's on the SmackDown side, as we're gonna take down Riley's World. Simple as that. Riley's World's gone. And here we go. Look at this. Again, going to work right here, man. These two guys are just going to do what they need to do here tonight to pick up a win here on Friday night, just to send up a message to each side. You know, Ray wants to send a side to the SmackDown roster that you guys are don't stand a chance against Riley's World. And Juan wants to send a message to Riley's World that they're coming to an end. It's over for them. They're going to end soon, and that's it. And we will never see Riley's World here in the WWE again. But Rey Mysterio right now in total control of the match, and that's how you do it. Moves like that, a pinfall, this could be the end right here. Kick out by Juan. Rey Mysterio taking back to the work again, man. You have to figure out how is Juan going to pick up this win here against a quick, speedy guy like Rey Mysterio, who is very crafty and knows how to get a win out of nowhere. And that's what Juan needs to protect against here tonight. An elbow to the back of the head of Rey Mysterio. You better watch yourself, Rey. You gotta watch yourself, man. A backbreaker. What is going on here? Lifting him up. Drop out. Down. My goodness gracious, man. Come on. The pinfall. The win. Rey Mysterio is done. Kick out by Rey Mysterio. Now, right now, I'm thinking, what is Riley Sparks doing right now? Is he watching this match? Is he watching, you know, the return of Juan? And, you know, what is AJ Styles thinking now that Juan is back? And he did turn his back on Juan, and now he's facing his tag team partner of AJ Styles. You know, it's like the two last partners of AJ Styles, tag team partners, going at it right now. And look at that frog splash. That could be it. That could be the win. Yes. Oh. Oh, my goodness gracious. No, Rey Mysterio not able to get it yet going. And, oh, Juan able to dodge that one. He's dodging and weaving. And now he wants to call for the possible end match move maneuver. Maybe not. He just goes with that right there. For the pinfall, for the win, Rey Mysterio is out. Kick out by Rey Mysterio. Mysterio kicking out. And look at Juan going back to work again now, lifting him up. Dropping him back on his back. Not a bad maneuver by the kid. And he's going back for the pin, going for the win, going for the win. Now kick out by Rey Mysterio. Here tonight on SmackDown, man, a great night. We are expecting a title defense here tonight by Wade Barrett. He will defend that European Championship against former NXT rookie Ryan Duggan. And that's going to be one hell of a match. But here comes the pin. This could be the win. This could be it. Kick out by Juan. Oh, man. You know, Rey Mysterio and AJ Styles are still trying to figure out who Daniel Bryan, you know, what Daniel Bryan has to do with the tag team titles now. You know, he lost his chance. You know, he lost his partner, William Regal, last week. Regal, after losing to Riley Sparks, retired. And I'm telling you, Riley Sparks is not shut up about how he defeated William Regal and how he forced him to retire. It's getting quite annoying, actually. And I hope someone shuts him up about it. But who is Daniel Bryan going to select as a tag team partner now? That's the question. That's the main question here tonight. You know, who's D. Bryan going to pick as his partner? And the suplexes. Wait, the Three Amigos. Oh, my God. Look at this right here. Two great Latino wrestlers doing a little tango maneuver that was made by one of the greatest Latino wrestlers of all time. That was the Three Amigos, which was made popular by Eddie Guerrero. And now you know. Here goes. One, another one. Oh, he missed it. He missed it. Rey Mysterio was able to move a little to the side and come into it. Now Rey looking at what he could do to win this one right here. Oh, look at Rey. The fans know exactly what's coming. Now Rey's going to do his little stick, and he's going to do what he does best. And look at this, dodging that punch. And look at that high-flying maneuver by Rey Mysterio. And the fans are just like, oh, come on, man. Don't do this. Don't. And here comes Rey. A Luthor surprise on Juan. And he needs to pick it's the pace up now, man. But look at the reversal right there by Juan. Juan's not like, I got this. I got to close this one out. I got this. And he gets an elbow to the back of the head, taking control back to the slow pace that he wants to go back into. He's fought Rey Mysterio before. He knows how he needs to defeat Rey Mysterio. And a big time in security right there by Mr. Rey Mysterio comes right at you. And look at that kick right. Look at that little leg roll right there, like Drooly, Bully Sholy. And look at Juan now going back to work, and look at that, man. Again, this guy, you know, he has idols such as, you know, such as Eddie Guerrero, you know, Rey Mysterio, Chavo Classic, guys like that. You know, that's who he's really gone into. Guys like, you know, just guys that are like that, you know. Just guys like that. Luchador style, baby. You know, El Santo. I know that's one of his heroes from when I talked to him before about who he inspired his skills. He said El Santo was a guy in Mexico, you know, that really inspired him to do it. He knew that guy was very, very popular, but, you know, he inspired him, and he saw him as a kid, and he was like, yeah, why not? But, you know, guys like that, just, this guy isn't afraid to show his heritage, but at the same time, he is also not afraid to kick some ass. But who isn't afraid to kick some ass nowadays? Rey Mysterio trying to kick some ass right here, but it's not going to happen. Trust me, Riot Sports not going to go. I don't even know where this commentary is going here tonight. That's the beauty of Friday Night SmackDown. We have nobody on commentary but a monkey. A DDT on my fucking table. I'm done. Someone needs to tell these guys to stop putting people through my table, because that was one wicked DDT through the table. And my tables are always breaking. These come out of my pockets, guys. And look at, oh, come on, Rey Mysterio trying to win the match like this. We know the old Rey Mysterio will not try to do this right here. The old Rey Mysterio will not try to win a match like this. But look at Rey. Rey's like, you can't handle me, man. Rey's going like, okay, you know what? I'm going to send a bigger message to the SmackDown locker room by bringing you in here and getting that 1-2-3 victory over you. I don't need this kind of win. Here we go. Rey's going for that splash. That splash by Rey Mysterio, able to be a dodge. Dodged by Juan. Now he's looking for something here. Here we go. Rey coming right at you, running at you. And look at this. He caught him. Lies him in the middle of the ring. This could be it. Oh, wait. What's he doing? One more. Wait, what the hell is this? Small guy. Look at Rey. Just got flattened like a damn pancake. Rey lost it. And Juan picks up the win. A comeback win after his comeback last week, where he laid out Riley Sparks. Now he lays out Rey Mysterio. And apparently he laid out Ezekiel Jackson as well last week. So, you know, he only needs two more members of Riley's World to lay out. And he laid down all the members of that team. But he knows the job is not done until he takes that Intercontinental Championship away from Riley Sparks. But again, you know, I don't think he has enough. I don't think he's done enough in this 2 weeks, in last week and this week, to you know, make a case for why he should be the Intercontinental number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. There's other guys in the back that can give you a case to why they should be. A guy like Wade Barrett can go like, I've been defending my European title every single week. Maybe it's time I get a chance at the Intercontinental Championship. A guy like anyone else out there, you know, a Ryback could come in and, you know, say, maybe I want a chance at the Intercontinental Championship and not the U.S. Championship. You know, anybody could come into it. Even Kofi, if he says, hey, maybe I have a chance at the King of the Ring, but maybe I want a chance at that. You know, even anybody could take that right now. This guy, he still needs a little bit more work to do. He needs to piss off Riley Sparks just right enough to get that title shot. Wait, oh no! Oh my god, no, not this! Yeah, of course, this is where Riley Sparks' plan right here. Bring out the team. Bring out the three guys that you're best acquainting with. Bring out three of the four guys that you're best acquainting with. You know, Ryan Sparks isn't in here. I don't know where he's probably protecting his little buddy. And look at that. A Styles clash. Oh, my God. AJ Styles, did you really just do that to your mentor, your former tag team partner? Your mentor from NXT, not mentor from Roller. From all that. But here we go. And now they're all just trying to get a piece of him, trying to lay him out. And look at Ezekiel Jackson with that big time clothesline. A kick to the side of the head. Man, this right now is a beatdown now. And look at Ezekiel dropping him. DDT. AJ Styles 450 splash. And look at this torture rack right here by Ezekiel Jackson. Juan has nothing but to tap, man. Even if he taps, it's not like, oh, yeah, it's done. No, these guys are too, really. And, you know, they had a long little matchup. Tired of telling you, sneak attack. this guy right. You know what? I hope you get what's coming to you, Riley's World. I really hope you three get what's coming to you guys. I hope you two lose the title, and I hope Ezekiel Jackson becomes a fat old haired reman. That's what I hope that happens to you guys. Yeah, that's what I hope happens. What is going on back here? There's a reason why he's been the champion since the Royal Rumble. There have always been full of surprises, even bigger than here at Money in the Bank, but I see I'm full of surprises too. I attacked Edge. That is true. If Christian did not set these motions of attacks, Shelton Benjamin might not be the World Heavyweight Champion at the Royal Rumble. It'll be in a steel cage match, oh baby! Oh baby, Christian Shelton Benjamin in a steel cage match! Oh yeah! At King of the Ring, Christian and Shelton Benjamin for that World Heavyweight title. The clock ain't close to midnight yet. The Cinderella Man is saying he will defeat Christian at King of the Ring in their steel cage match to end it all. To end their epic matchup, their epic rivalry, it will come to a close at King of the Ring in a steel cage. But it's time for a little bit of tag team action. These guys are not happy at all. Perfection 3.0. Perfection 1.0 was Dolph Ziggler alongside David Arquette. David Arquette later on was let go. And then it was Perfection 2.0 with Dolph Ziggler, Mark Henry, Mason Ryan, and Richie Steamboat. Then Richie Steamboat was dropped. And Perfection 3.0 is alive now with these three gentlemen right here. Two big time powerhouses together and Dolph Ziggler. You know, what can you say? I don't know what else you can say about it, but Dolph Ziggler has aligned himself with some big heavy dudes, but they have not been able to help him out because the Ryback has just been running rampant on these guys and just coming in. And we saw it on Monday Night Raw. Mark Henry was shell-shocked by the man known as the Ryback, and so was Mason Ryan. They were both shell-shocked, and Ryback sent in a message to Perfection. Here comes Trent Barretta, who will be teaming up with the Ryback here tonight. The Ryback looking to prove to everyone, looking to prove to Ziggler, telling Ziggler, I want a chance at the title, but Ziggler keeps dodging and weaving him. But Ryback hopefully wants to make the message clear, the message loud, that he wants that U.S. title, that he needs to win that title. That's right, that's my virus system. In your face. And there's Ryback just... No, Ryback, man, he wants a title, and he thinks U.S. title right now is okay right now at the moment. but he wants that U.S. title. He thinks he's run into that line right now. He thinks he deserves the title. Why doesn't he? You know, he's been winning matches after matches. He's been beating guys like Mark Henry up, and that's not an easy feat to do, to beat up a guy like Mark Henry. Look at the size of Mark Henry, man. Trent Barreta trying to fight with Mark Henry. These punches are not doing nothing to Mark Henry. Mark Henry's saying, come on, punch me. And Mark Henry now laying down this big man. Laying down this big man known as Trent Barreta, the B-man. The big man. Trent who? Trent Barreta, that's his name. Got taken out by everybody. And look at that sideway knocking him out. Not a bad move by Mark Henry. Mark Henry is doing what he needs to do right now to win. And how are you going to beat Mark Henry? That's another question. You know, Mark Henry... I'm telling you, if I was Trent Barreta, I'm thinking, how am I going to beat Mark Henry? Let's say something happens, Ryback goes down, and Ryback can't help me out. Now I have to beat Mark Henry and Mason Ryan. How am I going to do it? It's a very tough challenge, but I think I can pull it off. I just have to use my speed and quickness. Simple as that. It's what's got me to the dance. Just use what's got me to the dance. But now the tag team maneuver right there. A beautiful little tag team partnership right there between Mason Ryan and Mark Henry. Mason Ryan, the beast from Wales. You know, this guy's from a place that just sounds like carnage. That's what he does to his opponents, man. He lays them out. He leaves the carnage in the ring. And, you know, there's the neck breaker by Barreta out of nowhere. Barreta with the beautiful neck breaker. I think Barreta's thinking Ryback time. Wait, oh, come on. Look at Trent Barreta. He's like, I don't know if I should tag you. Trent Barreta has always been that guy, like, that's been like, you know, you don't impress me. Nobody impresses me. That's the guy he's always been, that no one impresses me. I'll do whatever the hell I can want to do. Whatever I say goes, you know, just like that. I'm just that guy. Nothing really impresses me. I'm like, what else? What else do you got? And nothing will really impress Barreta, but, you know, and look at Henry. But maybe that impresses him a little bit to know that Mark Henry is the world's strongest man and can hurt you like that. But Ryback, man, he needs to figure himself out right now over there. How do I get my partner, Trent Barreta, to tag me in so I can come in and lay these suckers out? But look at Mark now. Mark Henry looking for the close, looking to put this match to bed. Here it is, World Strongest Slam. Oh, I thought he was going for the war. You tricked us. You trolled us, Mark Henry. He was going for the World Strongest Slam right there, but apparently not. Mark is looking like, I got this. But look at Trent trying to summon the energy here. He's able to knock him out. Oh, no. Trent Barreta again knocks out Mark Henry. Does it again. Trent don't mess this up. A drop kick to drop the big man. Ryback is... Look at Ryback. He's telling him, come on, man. Trent's trying to get the tag in. Trent fall down. He fell down. And now he's going for the tag. Mark Henry's up. And here comes the Ryback. Ryback is in the ring. The beast. The man. Machine. The man who destroys anything in his path. The human wrecking ball. Ryback is in the damn ring. Ryback is in, just staring at Mark Henry. These two guys staring at each other again. Knowing what happened on Monday Night Raw. Mark Henry's telling Ryback, come at me, bro. Let's go. This is a battle I've been looking for. We saw it on Monday Night Raw, and we're going to see it here on SmackDown again. Ryback and Mark Henry, the world's strongest man versus the human wrecking ball. And look at that. Mark Henry just being thrown out. Trent Barreta being tossing Mark Henry back in the ring. Wow, impressive strength. And Ryback knocks down Mason Ryan. And he's calling for it. He wants to call it and finish it. But look at Mark Henry able to take down the Ryback. Ryback is in trouble. Here comes the punches by Mark Henry. Oh, he got caught with that kick up big time. Clothesline by Ryback. And Ryback, what are you doing, Ryback? What are you doing, Ryback? Powerbomb, my God, on Mark Henry. A powerbomb on Marquise Henry, I don't know, fudge it. On Mark Henry, Ryback right now, hoping to prove to everyone that he belongs with each other, that he belongs as a sidewalk slam. On Mark Henry, the strength and power, and look at Ryback, meat hook. Bam, the meat hook. Clothesline. He's calling for it. Finish him. It's over. Put it, lift him up. Oh, I thought he was going for that shell shock, but no. Here comes the world's strongest slam. Reversed. Beautiful reversed by the kid named Ryback. Ryback lifting him up here. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Ryback. Oh, no. I thought he was going crazy stuff. Wait. Yes, here we go. The move that has just finished every superstar off. The shell shock. Shell shocking. By golly. That was the shock heard around the world. Ryback and Trent Barreta defeat Mark Henry and Mason Ryan. Ryback and Trent Beretta picking up a very impressive win here on SmackDown. Can't take that away from these guys, man. Ryback hopefully hopes that this can nudge Edge into the direction of making that title match at King of the Ring happen. A match between Dolph Ziggler and Ryback for the United States Championship. I'm ready to see that happen. But we'll see what Edge thinks about it, but we'll see what happens. Let's get ready for our next match. Ryder, Kane, go. You know it! A participant in the King of the Ring tournament by defeating Alberto Del Rio last week here on SmackDown. The bro with the mo, Zack Ryder. Ryder, the Internet Champion, which is not an official title, but it's a very nice title, I'll give him that, is gonna go up against the Big Red Machine Kane here tonight. And as we now know it, you know, they now have new opponents going into the King of the Ring tournament. Kane will be facing the John Cena, while Kofi Kingston will be facing Randy Orton. Zack Ryder, though, he's going to have the pretty tough challenge in Seth Rollins. You are the king of the bros, man. You are the king of the bros. What can I say? I hope your luck changes too at this pay-per-view, man. You've been having a lot of bad luck. The Revolution. The Ryder Revolution starts at King of the Ring according to Ryder. Woo, woo, woo. You know it. What can I not say that has never been that has not been said about this man before, man? This is Kane. Simple as that. Think about evil. You think about this man. When you think about looking under your bed, you are afraid that you will find Kane there, just looking for you, looking to take you to the depths of hell. Kane, another participant in the King of the Ring tournament, and I don't know about you, but he's a favorite right here. You know. He was on main event, though. He was on main event in the little tag team match of the King of the Ring one, which is a pretty good tag team match. A little crazy result at the end with Kofi Kingston giving a trouble in paradise to John Cena, and then Cena being taken out. And he had Orton come in, give him a little something, and he had Cena at the end, though, would be the guy raising up. But Kane could be a very tough challenge at King of the Ring. You know, he's proclaiming himself as King Kane already. So Ryder's proclaiming himself the King of the Bros. You know, which one is more believable, King Kane or King of the Bros keys, Zack Ryder? But Ryder and Kane, they have a little history before. You know, they've been in stuff that we haven't really wanted to see, but they've been together before in the past. But now Kane, you know, looking to send a message to Zack Ryder here tonight, looking to send a message to everyone in that King of the Ring tournament. If Kane can destroy Zack Ryder, it's going to be something fun to watch. But if Zack Ryder can destroy Kane, then wow, that's a big shocker right there to the whole world. Zack Ryder, though, he's going into King of the Ring with probably, next to Heath Slater, the lowest chances of winning it. When you think about the talent you have in that King of the Ring, you have a guy like John Cena. You got a guy like Randy Orton. You got a guy like CM Punk, Kane, Kofi Kingston, and Seth Rollins of the Shield. And then you have just Zack Ryder and Heath Slater. Those two guys are probably the lowest chances of winning the tournament. So if Ryder was able to pull off this upset and win the King of the Ring tournament, it would be something that just, you know, we wouldn't have thought happened. But this is what Ryder is about. Ryder is about making you think, no, this guy can't. This guy can't do anything. This guy's not going to win. This guy's just a damn goofball. He's just going to get destroyed by the other guy. But this is what Ryder does, man. Ryder does things like these, and he wins. He tries to win, man. He hasn't hit that big one yet, though. So close to winning the Royal Rumble. He was the runner-up. So close to winning the World Heavyweight Championship at the Elimination Chamber, runner-up. He won the Money in the Bank at WrestleMania, but lost it because Brock Lesnar assaulted him and stole his Money in the Bank. He's come close to winning the Intercontinental Championship, but again, you know, two tries and it didn't happen. So, you know, it's all about, you know, what can Ryder really come in the clutch? And they have a guy like Kane who's been destroying everyone and everything in his path. Has run into a little bit of a roadblock with Kofi Kingston, though. Kofi Kingston was able to finally stop the rampant Kane. But, you know, Kane, though, we've seen what he can do. So we know he can turn it up at any time he wants. He can hit that switch to go, like, I'm going to destroy whoever I want to destroy. No one can stop me. And we'll see what happens, man. We'll see what happens with... God, look at Ryder again. Ryder coming at you very strong. That's what Ryder needs to do. Keep the game planning. Keep the game in your momentum. Do what you need to do, Ryder. You need to win this match, man. You need to win. Get some momentum build up for King of the Ring, because you're going to need it. You can't walk into King of the Ring losing like 7 straight matches, or else you're not really going to win. Nobody believes that. But here comes Ryder. It's time for that broski. Boo! The broski boot connect. Zack Ryder is on a roll. Is Ryder ready to go? Is Ryder ready to start going crazy? Kane with a big time boot right there to knock down Zack Ryder into... Oh, here we go. Here we go. This is it. Time to end the match right here. Kane signaling that choke slam from that way. Tombstone. Tombstone. Oh, I thought he was going for that tombstone power drive, but he goes for a power slam. They're always confusing me here, man. These guys are always coming after me. Confusing me. Calling for something. They don't give me what I want. But Ryder going for a big time leg drop. It's gotten to Paladin. A power bomb by Kane. What a power bomb. What a win for the Big Red Machine. No, a kick out at 2 by Zack Ryder. The Ryder Revolution trying to live on here on Friday night. SmackDown. Kane's asking for Ryder to get up. He's telling him, get up. And Kane, here we go. Vintage Kane is what we call it here. And there's the roll-up pin. The win. This could be it. Kick out. A kick out by the good sir himself. Of Zack Ryder, a knee to the face of Kane. And I wonder if that hurt Zack Ryder at all, because he is wearing a mask. Ryder got caught! Ryder was going for a high time, double X on. Oh. Kane's mad. Kane is upset at the referee. Ryder doesn't know what the hell's going on. He's just dizzy as fuck. Just laid out. No one knows what's going on here. Kane. Knocks on the referee. What the hell? Wait. Here, he's got a sledgehammer, but this is not. Look at Kane. He's trying to destroy the referee. Kane is still mad about the referee's count earlier. Look at Kane trying to strike the referee. Okay, now Kane stopped. Thank God. The referee is as quick as a fox. Oh, wait, no. Kane. Look at Kane really trying to knock out the referee, and now he's got him. No! Ryder, get the sledgehammer, Ryder. Whoop his ass with the sledgehammer. Ryder choking Kane out. Ryder is choking Kane out. The referee's like, what's going on? I don't know what's going on. Referee just ignoring what just happened. Referee, I guess you have to be fair, but come on. You know what? Just look the other way. I'll give you $5. Just look the other way. Ryder didn't use that sledgehammer at all. Ryder now going to work here. Ryder looking for a DDT. Can he hit it? Yeah, he got it. He got it. He got that DDT. He got what he needed to do here. And now Ryder coming to lift him up. Lift him up. Lift him up. And Kane's going right to the floor right there. And that's how you do it, man. If you don't get your win like that, then who's going to beat you like that? And look at Ryder. Powered by Ryder. What the f- We haven't seen that power from Ryder in 3 years. And now Zack Ryder wants to call it, wants to put the Ryder Revolution on top, but Kane able to reverse the move. And now Kane's got, oh, look at this, submission. A submission move just puts his whole freaking hand over Ryder's face, cutting off any circulation of breathing. And Ryder's passed out. Ryder's passed out. Ryder is passed out. Referee has no choice but to call it. Kane picks up the victory. Kane wins. He suffocated him, is what he just did. Kane just suffocated him, man. Just look at that right there, suffocating Zack Ryder. And if he's able to do that in if he's able to do that King of the Ring, he's definitely gonna win the tournament, man. He'll definitely be the next King of the Ring. Kane, don't do the celebration, man. You I hate him. But Kane proving why he might win the King of the Ring tournament. Are we looking at our future King of the Ring in Kane? Hashtag King Kane. Is that what's going to happen? Hashtag King Fruit Rollups. What's going on back here? These two guys are about to go in one-on-one action very soon. Here on Friday Night SmackDown. Right. I don't know what's going on here because our camera crews weren't ready. They didn't bring the microphone, so now they can't record what they're saying. Well, come on, man. Come on, Wade. It's a cheap shot before the match. You're really trying to get a little cheap shot before your title defense. Are you afraid that Ryan Duggan's going to take that title? Gotta go far. That don't mean that we gotta fall apart. I'ma stand tall for all of us. Cause fate on the phone. And it's time for a championship match. Wade Barrett has to defend that European championship again. Remember, that European championship is defended once a week, every week. He needs to defend that title every week, and he's been very successful since he's won it over when he beat Slater and Justin Gabriel. Pretty much Slater held that European Championship, but Wade Barrett won. Wade Barrett has seen challenger after challenger, and Wade Barrett has put them into the wasteland and got a half-leg Boston Crab on those guys. And we'll see what happened with Wade Barrett here tonight. And he takes on the rookie of NXT. The man that people doubt and what this guy can do, and they say he's just Dolph Ziggler's little B. And here comes the challenger, the guy named Ryan Duggan. And you're probably wondering, Duggan, I've heard that name before. Why? Hacksaw Jim Duggan? No, this ain't. No, this is not his son. This is his nephew. This is Ryan Duggan. Jim Duggan's nephew. What is he going to do tonight? Can Duggan defeat Wade Barrett, or will Wade Barrett retain? We'll see what happens. Here we go, man. I'm ready for this one right here. Duggan, Wade Barrett. Two former NXT rookies are about to go at it in that very ring here on Friday Night SmackDown. We fight on Friday night. Is Wade Barrett's championship run about to come to an end by on the hands of Ryan Duggan, or will Ryan Duggan find a way to screw this one up and lose to Wade Barrett? We're about to find out, and here they go, trading punches, trading kicks, trading all this and that. The bare knuckle brawler from the great United Kingdom, Wade Barrett, fighting the man known as Ryan Duggan. You know, Duggan, people were thinking to themselves, this guy, he ain't no good. He ain't no good. He's only here because of his name, his last name. And you know, if that's the way you think about it, that's the way you think about it. No one's going to change your mind about it. But the guy, you know, he's put on some hell of a matches in his career on NXT. You know, you go to NXT, he probably stole the show a lot of times alongside his NXT pro, Dolph Ziggler. And that's why I think Ziggler taught this kid right here how to steal the show. You know, might have not taught him a lot of things, but the one thing he did teach him was, how do you steal the show? How do you do that? You know, you don't always have to win to steal the show. And he's done it before. I'm telling you, that NXT Redemption match he had with Dolph Ziggler, that Iron Man match that turned into a sudden death match in a steel cage, that was one hell of a match for this kid right here. One way to come into the WWE and show everyone, this is what I can do. But, again, I gotta tell you, you know, Duggan needs to put the past behind him now. He needs to put anything that isn't part of his future. We know who his uncle is. We know what he's done on NXT. But it somehow keeps finding him again. Dolph Ziggler keeps finding him every single week. Somehow, for some reason, Ziggler is still obsessed with defeating this kid. Now, this kid, in my opinion, he did defeat Dolph Ziggler at NXT Redemption, but the record books will show you that he didn't. But I don't know what the referee was smoking that day, but they were smoking something. But Dolph Ziggler and Ryan Duggan, man, you know, something just tells me it's not over yet. You know, something tells me Ryan Duggan has to win this match tonight. You know, to prove to Ziggler, hey, leave me alone. I'm a champion now, and I don't want this crap. And if you want to face me, put your title up against my title, and we'll see what happens there. But Wade Barrett, another guy, though, he's been coming out here every single week defending that title. I don't think a lot of people grasp at that right there, that Wade Barrett comes out every single week with not knowing whether or not he will win the match or not. You know, he comes out here, goes and puts the title on the line, says, hey, you know, here's my title, we're gonna fight. I have to do this because this is the title I've chosen to, you know, to have. The title that I have. I have to defend it every single week against a different random opponent. My opponents know everything about me. Me, I just don't know what the hell's going on. I know until like 30 minutes before the match, I know who I'm taking down for the European Championship. Wade Barrett might be in trouble. It's the title lost. No, Duggan able to. Duggan got caught. And here we go. Wade Barrett going back to work. And there comes a big time clothesline. And look at this. A knee to the gut of Barrett. Barrett looks like he could be in trouble. It's time. Oh, Duggan was looking to probably put the end there. And look at Wade Barrett with a beautiful bulldog right there. Wade Barrett might be on the verge of winning this one right here. Wade Barrett for the pin. The win. And now kick out by Mr. Duggan with a big time beautiful catch right there. And now we look at this right here, channeling his inner Ziggler right here, what Ziggler has taught him to do, stealing the show like this. Might not agree on everything, Ziggler and Duggan, but that one thing, again, to steal the show is what they've agreed, and that's what Ziggler's trying to do here tonight. But wait, Barrett catches him with a beautiful belly-to-belly suplex right there. Now it's time for the pin. It's time for a win. Ziggler could get it. No. Sorry, Duggan could. Wade Barrett could get it. Whoa. Dolph Ziggler's on my mind right now, man. Dolph Ziggler is on my mind because of this kid, Ryan Duggan, man, who's his rookie. And a lot of people call Ryan Duggan a Dolph Ziggler wannabe, and I don't see it, man. You know, he doesn't have the blonde hair. You know, he doesn't have anything else. You know, he doesn't have that six-pack abs. That 12-pack ab from Ziggler. You know, I don't know, man. But the one common if they're comparing him to Ziggler because of the fact that he's able to steal the show, then that's a good thing. But if it's not, then I don't know. But Duggan's on the verge of losing this one because Wade Barrett is now looking to go for the pin. Ziggler got it. It's over. No, kick out. Why do I keep calling him Ziggler? I think I'm just in the zone right now where... Oh, there's an elbow by Duggan. Right now I'm just in the zone because I've seen these guys before compete. What? We've seen instant classics before by Duggan and Ziggler before in the past. We've seen it. And I think I'm just in that zone right now with Duggan right now. Because Duggan's doing that tonight again with Wade Barrett. Just making a match out of this. One hell of a match. Making Wade Barrett work. Making Wade Barrett scared that he might lose his title here tonight to Duggan. Duggan lift up. Getting lift up. Bam. So power slam by Barrett. Barrett for the win. Wade. He's got it. Oh, kick out by Duggan. Ryan Duggan is resilient right now. Go with a big time power slam like that. And now look at Duggan. Duggan, that's not how you're going to win this match. And Wade Barrett's waiting for you. Wade Barrett's like, I got this. And there's a big time clothesline. Wade Barrett shouldn't have been taunting then. And there's a big time beautiful, beautiful, beautiful famous sir. Wait, got caught with the kick. Belly, oh, baby, look at that move by Barrett. Barrett now looking to win, hoping this could have been the move to win the match. No, kick out by Duggan. Duggan is not. Oh, there's a power slam by Duggan. Ryan Duggan looking to capture the European Championship, looking to capture his first ever WWE gold. And it could happen here tonight on Friday Night SmackDown. Duggan, time for it. Swift, bam, kaboom. That's how you do it, man. Punch in the face of Wade Barrett. Come on, man. Come on. Come on, Duggan. Hit that dig dog. Whatever you want to call it, the dug dag. Here we go. Wade Barrett, though, it's back to control of the match. And Wade Barrett, the European champion for a reason. He's been able to win every single match with that title on the line because he knows how to close them out. And look at that elbow by Barrett. Barrett connected at the elbow. Barrett might be looking for Wade, so no, he's looking for a pin. He's looking to end it right here. It's over for Duggan. No, Duggan ain't able to kick out. Duggan catches him right there with that beautiful move right there. Now, Duggan, you have to close him out. Duggan has to close out Wade Barrett here. If he does not do that, he will be in a lot of trouble, my good sir, my good friends. And look at Wade Barrett. Got caught in the dug dag. The dig dag, the doogie dag, whatever. Wait, oh, That's Ziggler! That's Dolph Ziggler's music! Oh no, look behind you! Look behind you! Duggan! Duggan, no! Ryan Duggan distracted by the music of Ziggler! And now Wade Barrett capitalizes with the wasteland! Another wasteland just to make sure that Duggan does not kick out! And now he's grabbing the leg! Oh, this right here is just the insult right here, making Duggan tap. Look at that. Duggan's tapping. Duggan is tapping. Ziggler made his effect here tonight. Ziggler playing his music out there. And Wade Barrett wins. Wade Barrett is still the European champion. Thanks to the help of Dolph Ziggler's Titantron hitting. Wow. Wade Barrett laid out Wayne. I am out right there with that waistline. Did it twice, and he goes for the submission move that has been pretty much how he's been closing every single match since he's been the European champion. He closed it out like that. Duggan not able to save himself. Wade Barrett is still the European champion, and we'll see him next week defending that title again. But what is it with Dolph Ziggler still somehow obsessing with this young kid of Ryan Duggan? What's going on here, man? Costing him another match again. Cost him a match at Superstars. He cost him another one here tonight. I don't know what's going on with Ziggler, but he keeps, Duggan better watch himself. I think Ziggler is a stalker of his. Are you ready? No. I said this is the match right here. Heath Slater versus Kofi Kingston. Kofi Kingston and Heath Slater, two participants of the King of the Ring tournament, about to meet in a one-on-one action match. You've already seen Kane and Zack Ryder go at it, and tonight we're going to see Kofi and Slater go at it. You know, Slater not being picked by anyone to win the King of the Ring tournament. And you know what? I don't disagree with anyone. You know, I wouldn't pick this guy neither. This guy is, I think, the eighth guy to win the eighth guy in line to win it. You know, you have Cena, Orton, Punk. Who else is in that one? Ryder. Now Kane, you have Kane in there. Seth Rollins. A guy like Kofi Kingston. Kofi Kingston, though, a lot of people think this tournament could be made for him. It could be also made for John Cena, but he did send a strong message to John Cena by giving him a kick to the side of the head on main event. After the match, he went like, you know what? It's King of the Ring. It's everyone for themselves. You're not going to help me if I need your help. I already know that, and you know that. That's what's going to happen. But Kofi Kingston, man, you know, he's had his problem with Kane, but tonight he goes into the ring to take on another red behemoth. And Heath Slater. No, actually not really a red. He's just a redhead or ginger. Wait, you gotta believe in the Slater. Oh, baby. That's true. They don't make you a rock star. They make you hyper. Yeah, I'm getting spit over here too. I need like a flotation device when he says baby. Heath Slater's gonna beat CM Punk. That's right. Hit my trouble in paradise on you, old baby. The boom, boom, boom. We're ready to see Slater and Kofi Kingston here tonight. See who can get some momentum headed into the King of the Ring tournament. Slater, Kofi Kingston, you know, two guys who will be a part of that King of the Ring tournament. Now Slater's going to face CM Punk. Kofi Kingston will face Randy Orton. Now, there is no prior history between Slater and Punk, but there is some prior history with Kofi Kingston and Randy Orton. A lot of stuff goes into that, but you know what? We're going to see what happens at King of the Ring, but tonight we see what happens here on SmackDown between Kofi and Heath Slater, the leader of the Heath Slater and the Slaters. Kofi flying high, my God, the Jamaican sorry, the Ghana Africa sensation, the Ghana man. Gonna make me go crazy. Sensation is beating the crap out of Heath Slater right now. Just showing Heath Slater, hey, maybe you don't belong in that King of the Ring tournament. Maybe someone should take your spot. Maybe I should injure you so someone that actually deserves the spot takes it. Heath Slater, though, man. He thinks he believes it. He believes that he's going to be the new King of the Ring and the King of Rock and Roll. And Heath Slater for the pin, the win. Oh, Kofi was in a little bit of a predicament right there. But again, Kofi Kingston wants to win the King of the Ring just as bad as Heath Slater wants to. Because remember, the winner of the King of the Ring tournament gets an automatic match either for the WWE Championship or World Heavyweight Championship at Money in the Bank. Now, you know, if I was Kofi, I would go for the title that I know I can win. You know, just think about it. Kofi might be looking for a WWE Championship. Heath Slater might be looking for the W. Imagine if Heath Slater somehow magically wins the King of the Ring tournament and goes for the WWE Championship. Oh my goodness gracious. What are we going to get ourselves into? Yeah, all I know is that whoever the champion is, he's going to destroy Heath Slater like nothing. But Kofi going for the pin. Kofi kick out by Slater. You know, I think Slater has to, you know, if in my own little world, I think Heath Slater needs to win every single match he's put in from now on and then into King of the Ring. He needs to win every match at King of the Ring, obviously. But from now on, he needs to win every match to have the greatest momentum out of everyone there in the King of the Ring tournament and prove that you belong. Prove that, you know, that you are actually a serious threat. Prove that you have all the momentum. Simple as that. Just win every single match. As you start here tonight by defeating Kofi Kingston. Kofi Kingston, though, high-risk maneuver, knows how to do it. He knows what to do. Look at Slater. Looking to tear up things here, man. Looking to tear the ring up. Looking to do whatever he can. High risk time, Kofi. Kofi, high risk. Oh, God damn it. Oh, that was air. That was complete air. Heath Slater getting knocked down by Kofi Kingston. Kofi Kingston feeling it. Heath Slater's in trouble here tonight. Kofi Kingston showing us a little bit of his boom, 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 pow skills right here. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, that's right. Heath Slater is in trouble. Maybe Heath Slater knows that song, the boom, boom, boom. Since he is a rock star, remember that. And look at Slater, neck breaker. A neck breaker by Slater. Slater trying to prove to everyone, man, that he is the king of the rock and roll and the king of the ring. Heath Slater, though, he's going to have a tough challenge, man, at that king of the ring. He is on the tough side of the bracket. He is on the bracket that features CM Punk, John Cena, and a man by the name of Kane. So Heath Slater, you know, that was a pretty nice neck breaker by Slater, but he only has 25% of chance of winning. But let's take to realistic stats. I think he only has like 0.1% chance of winning. Kofi Kingston is on the table that features Randy Orton, Seth Rollins, and Zack Ryder. Now I think if Kofi can get past Randy Orton, you know, his next challenge, if it's Seth Rollins, will be something to deal with because of the Shield's involvement with it. But if you have a guy like Zack Ryder, you're facing him. You know, it's another fan favorite. I think you can defeat him. I think you can beat him. I think you can beat him. And there's a kick out. Unless Randy Orton somehow wants to change the tables again and we can't see, or we'll see CM Punk being traded into the him and Slater trading places with Kofi You know, him trading places, Heath Slater's little bracket trading places with Zack Ryder and Seth Rollins. You know, we'll see what happens. But, you know, King of the Ring bracket, I hope it's officially done. I hope we're going to see Punk and everyone and stay in their first round matchup and nothing else changes. Hopefully we keep it at that. But King of the Ring looks to be something nice and fun. And tonight these two guys are just there doing what they're supposed to do. Kofi Kingston, though, and he's had that rivalry with Kane, the big red monster. And now he's going high risk. This is how he was able to beat Kane, just going high risk like that. And, you know, he did kill the momentum of Kane, just like he killed Heath Slater here tonight. Oh, kick out by Slater. You know, he did stop the momentum of Kane. Kane was on a destructive path, and no one thought Kofi could do it. But Kofi stopped the momentum of Kane, and he did what he needed to do. And now he's hoping to start making people believe in the Kofi Kingston effect. Neckbreaker by Heath Slater. Slater neckbreaking it, man. Heath Slater, we finally found out the name of his band. It's called the Heath Slater and the Slaters. I wonder how Kurt Hawkins, Cyril Rex, Jinder Mahal feel about that. But they're just the Slaters, right? They're just the band. They're just the rest of the band. They're not the lead singer like Heath Slater. And we're still waiting for Heath Slater's first song. And the Slaters, you know, we're still waiting for their first song. It's apparently going to be called, Yeah, Baby! Or, yeah, you know, we're a four-man band, you know, we're the band. I don't know what Slater wants to stinking of here. But Slater got caught! You got caught into a freaking trouble in paradise. Kofi Kingston is walking out of here with a win. Oh, by God. Kofi is surprised. Dee Slater kicked out. I'm as shocked as anyone else. Dee Slater kicked out. Slater got him. Dee Slater got him. This could be it. The show is over. Oh, Kofi Kingston able to kick out. Both men kicking out of their finishers. Kofi needs to get it. Oh, Kofi feeling it. Kofi feeling the magic and the chops to knock down Slater. But look at Slater able to knock and stop the little comeback by Kofi Kingston. Kofi's in trouble. Wait, Kofi coming at you again with the punches, bringing you down. Slater's down. Here we go. Kofi fly like a freaking giraffe. Kofi Kingston's in full control of the match. Here we go. Boom. 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 Kofi Kingston is on that roll. Kofi Kingston for the pin and the win. Kofi, well, God damn it, Kane. Sorry, Kofi Kingston's in disbelief right now. He's thinking, how did he kick out of that one, man? How is he kicking out of all these fucking pins? And Slater going for a neck breaker. Kofi's down. A neck breaker able to break your neck. There's a reason it's called the neck breaker, because it's meant to break your neck. And Slater with an elbow, dropping the elbow on Kofi. And Slater's just attacking. He's not letting up right here on Kofi. He wants to lay him out right there with that neck breaker like that. Why not? And I think Slater wants it one more. He wants to lay him out right here. Wants to put the air guitar matchup. That's how you do it. That's how you win it on the high court, man. I don't know what he calls it, but you've just been babyfied. Kofi is out like a light. Oh, come on. Kofi is not out. Someone say blackout. So Dee Slater knows that you've just been hit with the SOS, please. Someone. Kofi Kingston wins the match. Kofi wins, defeats Dee Slater with that SOS. Who's going to stop the Ghanaian sensation? The man from Ghana. The Ghana make you crazy. The Ghana make you believe in him. Ghana make you believe in the Kofi Kingston. Dee Slater, though, gave one pretty good effort. I didn't expect to see this from Dee Slater, you know. I was just thinking Dee Slater's going to walk in here and get his ass kicked like he always does by Kofi Kingston. And Kofi, celebrate the win, man. You picked up the win. This is what you deserve right here. Deserve to party out the Wayne tonight, and we'll see what happens next time we see you here on SmackDown, or maybe Main Event, or maybe Superstars, or maybe Saturday Morning Slam. We'll see what happens with you, Kofi. We love you, Kofi. Maybe we'll see you on that WWE versus ECW /WCW pay-per-view that we got coming up soon. What's going on back here between Riley Sparks and Ryan Sparks on the left? Ryan Sparks, Riley Sparks on the right with the Intercontinental Championship. What's going on? These guys are members of Riley's World. I don't know. Maybe he's teaching him a little bit of stuff. I don't know what's going on back here. Since our monkeys aren't in the back with the microphone and everything going on there, so we can hear what's going on. But it does not look good for us. Looks like they're plotting something. Looks like they're scheming up. Looks like they're talking about coffee and donuts again. I don't know, man. We're about to see him in action, though. Tag team action coming up right now. We're about to see another part of Riley's World. Ryan Sparks and Ezekiel Jackson. We've already seen Ezekiel Jackson here tonight. He helped Rey Mysterio and AJ Styles lay out Juan. And now he's going to be in tag team action with Ryan Sparks as they take on the team of High Risk featuring Justin Gabriel and Tyson Kidd. And, you know, these guys have never tagged up in the ring, but, you know, they do spend a lot of good amount of time with each other since they are part of Riley's World and nobody else pretty much likes to spend time with these guys. You know, they are spending a good time out with each other. So we'll see if that little chemistry can help them defeat a team who has been tag teaming for a little bit of a while. Here they come. The one in yellow is Justin Gabriel. The one in red is Tyson Kidd, and they're donning their M&M colors here. The M&Ms, you know, the candy. High Risk is coming in the ring. And if they can pick up a win here tonight, oh my God. What will that be telling everyone else? That they are ready to take care of business. That they've just knocked down two parts of one of the SmackDown's most dominant teams, Riley's World. If they can knock down Ryan Sparks and Ezekiel Jackson, maybe they get a match against against Ray and AJ, and then maybe they defeat them, and then maybe they get a chance at the titles. Who knows? You know, they lost that tournament, though, but it wasn't their fault. They were laid out by Kurt Hawkins and Tyler Rex and Jinder Mahal and Heath Slater, the band. So they weren't really ever, they never really lost their spot in the tag team tournament, but who knows? But it's all out chaos here, because it's going to be is this a tables match? Is this what they were discussing? A tables sort of a match? When did Tyson Kidd change his colors to blue? I don't know, man. This is my SmackDown. This is where attires are scheduled to change. And as we can see right now, they're in trouble right here. They're in trouble. And look at that move by Tyson Kidd. But now look at Sparks going right after Kidd, telling him, "Oh, man, what do you think you're doing? What do you think you're doing? You're not going to beat us. You're not going to win." You know, I think this is what you got to do. Your Kidd and Gabriel, double team to take out Sparks. And then you double team to take out Zeke, because Zeke is the bigger guy. Which one of you is really going to be able to lift him up and put him through a table? I don't know which one of you is going to do it, but it's going to have to be a two-man game. So you don't want to get yourself put through a table like this guy's about to get put through a table. Oh, baby, he missed the table, though. He missed it. And look at Sparks. Oh, my God. Don't do it, Sparks. Don't do it, man. Oh, Tyson Kidd able to get out of the table. But right now, they're... Justin Gabriel knocking him out. Super kick. You've been laid out, Ryan Sparks. What's going on here? Justin Gabriel looking to lift up. Ryan Sparks might be in trouble. Oh, he missed the table by a good amount. And look at Ezekiel Jackson trying to put Tyson Kidd through a table, but Tyson Kidd able to come out now with the speed as Gabriel and Kidd are trying to take advantage of this match and trying to put guys through the table, trying to get this win. And let's see what's going on here. Justin Gabriel spinning around. Not a bad way to spin around if you're Justin Gabriel. As Justin Gabriel is going to work on Ryan Sparks right now, Tyson Kidd is trying to go to work on Ezekiel Jackson. Ezekiel Jackson being lifted up. We might be seeing the end right here for Ezekiel. Oh, but look at Ryan Sparks coming out of nowhere to save his tag team partner here. And again, you know, Gabriel and Kidd trying to win the match, trying to prove to everyone that, you know, maybe they deserve a chance at the tag team titles. You know, they didn't lose in the tag team tournament. They were taken out completely. They were put in a spot where you couldn't compete anymore. And Ryan Sparks and Ezekiel Jackson are friends, are a team with AJ Styles and Rey Mysterio, the tag team champions. And I think Tyson might be in trouble because Ezekiel Jackson has him over a table. But Ryan Sparks might have Justin Gabriel in trouble because Gabriel might be in trouble here. Oh, look at Sparks, though. Ezekiel Jackson going high risk. This is not what you see every day. And he knocks down Tyson Kidd. And look at... Oh, my God. No. God damn, no. That's it. Justin's out. Justin Gabriel is out. And now... And now Sparks is looking at Kidd right now, telling him, yeah. And that doesn't count. That doesn't count. Someone has to put you through a table. Super kick! Tyson Kidd is out. Out like a light. Get the table. This match is over. How is Tyson Kidd going to be able to beat Ryan Sparks and Ezekiel Jackson? Look at Ezekiel Jackson just dominating poor Tyson Kidd right now. And Sparks right now is just like, we got this. We won this one already. Gonna put him through a table right now. And this is the way he does it. Why a spear? Oh, he went through a table. Tyson Kidd able to get out the way. Tyson Kidd says, "I'll get out the way." Oh, but look at Ezekiel Jackson though. Ezekiel Jackson saying, "I'm not giving up." But look at Sparks though. Sparks getting up. Sparks is thinking to himself, "How do I take this kid down?" And Ezekiel Jackson comes with the table and says, "This is how we're gonna do. We're gonna lift, get a table, and we're gonna knock his ass out." And look at Ryan Sparks. pile driver on Tyson Kidd. A pile driver on Tyson Kidd. You got to put him through a table, though. That's the one thing. You got to put him through a table. If you don't put him through a table, then what has this all been about? And he's throwing him right into the ring post, man. Sparks and Ezekiel Jackson now have the ability to beat down Tyson Kidd until they feel that it's no longer needed. And we're looking at this right now. Ryan Sparks, come on. Missed that one by the table, but look at that. Tyson Kidd able to save himself. Tyson Kidd's got a table, but Ezekiel Jackson, again with the number games, game is showing why it is very important. They are setting up tables. There's one table being set up, and here's another. Oh, he caught the wrong guy. Ezekiel Jackson. Tyson Kidd was like, I got to move to the side, and he caught him, and he now has him on the table. But now, look at this. Now Ryan Sparks is like, I got this. I know what I'm doing. Let me do what I'm doing. Yep, set him up. Elbow! Oh, he went through the wrong table. Wait. He went through the table. He put him through the table. He put him through a table, unfortunately. We are going to end up on Botchamania one of these days. Ryan Sparks, Ezekiel Jackson win here tonight on Friday Night SmackDown. Man, I'm sick and tired of these guys, man. These guys of Riley World. I'm sick of it. I don't want to see them win. Does it look like I want to see them win? No, I don't want to see them win. Thank God they're off the air already now. Seems like we're all about tag team action here on SmackDown, where the younger superstars shine. This is the show. Well, the show that's apparently better than Raw. That's what we want to give it here. That's what we do here on SmackDown. Tensai O'Raw, superstar, making a debut, an appearance here on SmackDown. The undefeated Tensai. Yes, he is undefeated in singles competition, but in tag team action, he has never been pinned. But he's been defeated, but he's never been pinned. And that's the one thing Tensai will bring to your attention, that he's never been pinned. Yes, he's lost tag team matches, but that wasn't his fault. The fault laid on the hands of his tag team partners. So tonight he's hoping to pick up the win here when he teams up with another superstar who's been doing quite well himself and attacking NXT rookies, Antonio Cesaro, to take on another team that, well, might give him a challenge. But here comes Tensai, though. Tensai, he's been here before in the WWE before, formerly known as Albert A-Train, Prince Albert, whatever you want to call him. He now came from a sabbatical in Japan. The city, you're dumb. Durr. That's what happened on SmackDown. That's what goes on here, man. The land of the rising sun. That's where Tensai went and came back and became all crazy and felt that he's perfected his art of wrestling. And here comes the man who already believes he's perfected the art of wrestling, just like he's perfected five different languages, Antonio Cesaro. Pretty good superstar, very gifted in that ring, can out-wrestle some people, can wrestle, outpower some people as well. I don't know if he can outpower Tensai, but it would be something special. But this past Tuesday, we saw him attack an NXT rookie, his former tag team partner on the Indies. He attacked Cassius Ohno. He attacked Cassius Ohno. He sounded like Cashew Ohno. But here comes their opponents. The DiBiase Posse, the $1 million champion, Ted DiBiase. The son of the WWE Hall of Famer, Ted DiBiase Sr. Here's Ted DiBiase Jr. Again, he was out there, man, tailgating with the fans, loving it. Loving the fan interaction, man. I wanted over there again. And they kicked me out because they said I would eat all the bacon that they were making. They were making some bacon hot dogs, and what can I say, man? I love me bacon hot dogs, but Ted didn't want to give me none because he said I've been taught bad-mouthing him. I did not bad-mouth you, man. I just want a bacon hot dog. That's all I want. That's all I've ever wanted, a bacon hot dog. Maybe two bacon hot dogs. I just want. But Ted's going to have quite a challenge here tonight with Cesaro and Tensai. Time to call your mama, son. Brodus Clay and the Funkadactyls making their way to the ring. Brodus Clay will team up with Ted DiBiase here on SmackDown to take on Cesaro and Tensai. Now it's Tensai and Brodus Clay. These guys have been on, their own winning streaks, but something's got to give tonight. We've already seen Tensai lose that tag team action. You know, I want to see Tensai and Brodus Clay one on one in that ring, see who loses their winning streak, man. These two guys virtually are coming in at the same time like these. You know, Brodus Clay was the bodyguard for Riley Sparks, but then was fired. Came back as the dancing Brodus Clay. And, you know, he says he's feeling it. He feels the funk. He feels that he's had so much funk to give that the funk of tears will be funking all the way, all the funkin' day. The whole funkin' day. The whole funkin' day, the people will be funkin' dactyls. And funk, they will be funking all day as well. Funk, funk, funk. But Ted DiBiase tonight, you know, maybe he could have used some funk at that DiBiase tailgate out there. DiBiase posse tailgate out there. So it's going to be Tensai and DiBiase to kick this one off. Tensai taking it. Oh, look at DiBiase getting rid of Tensai quick and fast. Like wow, like a pinball. He just, like, popped him and wants to get the hell out. And now the tip of the push is coming back in now. Tensai now trying to take control of the match. This is what he's done for quite a while. He takes control of the match, drops you down, and beats you up. There's nowhere else to say, nothing else to say. He's just pretty good at what he does. And I don't think you can stop a man like Tensai in singles competition. And maybe in tag team you can. You go right after his partner, and here comes Cesaro knocking you down. That's what Cesaro does pretty good. And he gives you suplexes as well. Cesaro's a pretty talented guy, man. Besides the fact that he knows five different languages, you're welcome. He is a man of mystery, the international man of mystery, the WWE's James Bond. Yes. Cesaro. Antonio Cesaro. That's what his name reads. And he's going right after DiBiase here tonight, man. Last night we saw him on Superstars pick up a win in a mixed tag team match against Trent Beretta and Maxine. He teamed up with his lover Oksana. They picked up the win and it wasn't that bad. It was actually a pretty good win for Cesaro. I guess that's a win. Oh, look at that. Look at that move right there by DiBiase. Ted DiBiase trying to get on the good graces of the fans here in the WWE. And since he's made his, since they pretty much traded him, since he's been traded over here to SmackDown, he's trying to make the best of it. Remember, he lost to his brother Bret DiBiase in a match where the loser will leave Monday Night Raw, and now he's arrived here on SmackDown hoping to make the best out of it, hoping to, you know, win over these peeps. You know, you got to win over the peeps to be somebody in the WWE. And Ted DiBiase said, I know how to win over peeps. That's the way you do it. Give him a butt buster. A butt buster, people. The butt buster is in the building. And Ted DiBiase getting flipped around like a dang pancake. And here we go. Cesaro coming after you. Cesaro tagging in the big bad Tensai. Tensai might be looking to make some extra damage, some extra meat out of Ted DiBiase. DiBiase is in trouble if Tensai can get what he wants. Here we go. DiBiase needs to wake up. It's what he needs to do. Simple as that. If he doesn't wake up in this match, he's not going to win. If he stays asleep like this, you know, we're just going to see a complete domination by Tensai and Cesaro. And look at Tensai High Risk! That's a big-time splash. Bros Clay, though, coming in to save his partner. Coming in to save him. And what a big kick by Tensai. That would take back the momentum for Tensai and Cesaro. So, oh, that's it. Look at this right here. Just domination of Ted DiBiase. Ted, you got to wake up, man. The Funketeers and the Funkadactyls. And the big funk master himself, Brodus Clay. The Funkasaurus. God, look at Tensai, though. As the Funkasaurus has to watch his partner here tonight get beaten down. This could be it. Kick out by DiBiase. DiBiase gets kicked to the ground again. DiBiase needs to wake up before Tensai realizes it's time to put him out of commission. Tensai's tagging in Cesaro. Walk into that spine buster, why don't you? Now Cesaro cracking his neck. There's only one thing left to do. Hit the neutralizer. Oh, he was thinking. I think he was thinking neutralizer. And Ted said, but Ted falling on his back. That's not good. That's not what you want to see if you're Ted. Ted's running, though. Ted's running to Brodus. Brodus, wait, what's he doing? He's talking to Brodus. He's telling him, you know what? I got this. Don't worry about me. I know what I'm doing here. Just let me handle this. And everything is just going crazy here on Friday nights. Everything has just gone to the outside. The DiBiase boy is going wild on Cesaro, bringing him back in the ring. I think he might be thinking, it's time for some Dream Street, maybe a magical Dream Street. The magic, what's it called? The miracle on Dream Street. That's what we're looking for. And here comes the big Funkadactyl himself. Nah, I'm just kidding. The big Funkasaurus himself, Brodus Clay, with a big time headbutt on Cesaro, a man who can appreciate a good headbutt. You've just been received by a good headbutt. And look at now Brodus. Big Brodus all gets... Oh, now Cesaro takes control of it. I think... Oh, look at that headbutt. A retaliation headbutt. I told you, Cesaro appreciates a good headbutt. But, you know, he'll give you back that headbutt in return. You know, if you give him a headbutt, he'll give you a headbutt. And DDT! Wow, what a DDT by Cesaro. And I think what the fans are probably thinking is Cesaro can't pick up Brodus Clay, hit him up with the neutralizer. There's no way he can do that. You know, he's not going to do it. And since here comes Tensai, the big T himself. Tensai is going after Brodus Clay. This is what I was looking to see here tonight. The battle of the two behemoths right here. Brodus Clay, sit yourself down. Tensai, you've just been functified. And here comes Brodus. Big Brodus Clay. Somebody call his mama because he's about to go fly now. Oh, Tensai, though. Oh, no. Tensai, the ring could have fallen right there. Ring could have broken with that fall. One, two, Brodus is out. Brodus kicks out. Mr. Clay, how are you doing? Oh, you just got smacked by Tensai. I do not see the team of Brodus Clay and Ted DiBiase winning this one. Every time they get in the ring, you know, you think they're going to have something going, but it falls flat. But now here's Brodus Clay building that momentum again. Got him. Oh, Tensai with a beautiful reversal for a big man. Oh, he's looking to close this one out. Look at him just waiting in the wings. But look at Brodus. Brodus is now running around saying, ah, son. Oh, but Tensai says, I got this. No, there's no way you can lift the... My God, the power of Tensai to lift up Brodus Clay like that. And look at Tensai. Ready to end this. He's got the mist. He's going to go for that kick. Brodus says, son. Not like that. Time to give you a big splash. Like that. And drops the bomb. Come on, Brodus. Drop it. Drop that weight. Drop it. Here we go, Brodus. Oh, went right into the knees of Tensai. Tensai's looking for Cesaro right now. Looking for Cesaro. And Brodus is looking for Ted DiBiase. Ted's coming in. Cesaro gets taken down by that clothesline of Ted DiBiase Jr. The $1 million champion right now with a beautiful $1 million drop kick. And look at Ted just going like, yeah, this is exactly what I wanted to do. Ted, oh, look at that knee to that gut of Cesaro. Cesaro's like in... Like, oh, Jesus, oh, my goodness gracious. And here comes DiBiase to attack Cesaro. Cesaro in trouble. DiBiase is all filling DiBiase and the DiBiase posse are like, yeah, we ate. And now we get to see our leader of the posse just whoop some monkey tail. And there's a one, two, oh, not even a two. Cesaro kicking out at one, which is really emphatic right there. One, two, with the roll up. It's over. Kick out by DiBiase. I thought DiBiase was out. And look at that knockdown. While Brodus is working on Cesaro, but Cesaro gets worked out by DiBiase now with a beautiful neck breaker. But the referee is coming back to his senses. Here we go. DDT. DDT on Cesaro. A man who gave a great DDT earlier. Now receives a DDT by Mr. Ted DiBiase, but here comes Tensai into the ring. Tensai, not a happy camper right now. Not a very happy camper, but the tag team maneuver by these two guys was very flawless. Very good tag team maneuver by Tensai and Antonio Cesaro. These two guys, you know, there's the elbow again. Tensai and Cesaro really working like a good little piece right now. Two very strong-minded guys. Guys who think they are the best wrestlers, deserve everything, and they believe they are the guys that are going to be this show, this company is going to be built around. You got a guy like Ted DiBiase, though, who's trying to get back into the good graces of the fans. That's the way you do it, by not getting squished. Here comes a man who loves to give you the funk. The funk. Soares Rex. Brodus Clay with a big time sit down. To you, Tensai. And there's the elbow, man. Brodus Clay, you know, he's been coming on here on SmackDown. SmackDown Superstar. Trying to show everyone that he belongs here. Suplex! Suplex! That's what you know, need to know. And he's warming those legs. Oh, baby, look at it. Jab and shake. The jab and shake. What is Brodus thinking here? What is Brodus thinking? Oh, my God. Don't do it, Brodus. Brodus! Oh, Tensai. Able to say, I dodged it. And he drops the hammer on big bad Brodus Clay as he also drops an elbow on Brodus Clay. And what a bulldog by Brodus out of nowhere. That bulldog comes out of nowhere. Now a knee comes to the side of the head of Tensai. Tensai and Brodus Clay, man, two very hot superstars looking to whip each other's ass. They've been very hot in singles competition. And look at Tensai. What's Tensai thinking as Brodus is dancing? Tensai's thinking to him, so how do I beat this guy? And Brodus like, you can't beat me. I'm the gingerbread man. Brodus lifting it again. The sheer power of these two men to be able to lift each other up like that is pretty impressive. Now the Funkasaurus drops the weight. But again, Tensai scattered it perfectly and waited for the right moment to put those knees up. And here comes Cesaro and DiBiase. DiBiase got the quick roll-up. The quick roll-up. But the quick roll-up by Cesaro. The quick roll-up by DiBiase. DiBiase gets now the roll-up switch to Cesaro. The roll-up switches to DiBiase. The roll-up on the roll-up by Cesaro. Cesaro with the... Oh, there's a... DiBiase able to get out the way, but not able to get out the way of the big-time kick by Cesaro. What's Cesaro thinking right now, man? Oh, look at that uppercut. Probably one of the best maneuvers I've seen in the WWE in quite a long time. Throws his opponent up in midair and catches him with that uppercut. Neutralizer time right in the center of the ring. This match is over. Cesaro for the pin. The referee's counting out. Tensai wasn't able to get out. And Cesaro was like, what? What just happened? What just happened? The winners of this match are Brodus Clay and Ted DiBiase. And Tensai costing the win for his team. They had the win, man. They had the win. And Tensai wasn't able to understand the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can't be longer than 5 seconds in the ring when you're not the legal man. And he didn't understand that. The win for Ted DiBiase. And Brodus Clay. Time to celebrate, guys. Simple as that. You guys picked up a win. Cesaro on the ground crying, saying, what the hell is that? Wait, what's going on back here? What? Bryan exchanges title shot for an IC championship here tonight? Okay, you didn't beat him that bad. That's true. The titles do mean everything. Wait, what's Daniel pointing at? Oh, baby, it's one. I thought he was injured. I thought he got taken. And Riley's like, I didn't do nothing, man. I didn't even say that. And Riley's just says, oh, my goodness gracious. Riley Sparks falling back. What? That's what I want to see. He's acting like a little coward right now. He's like, okay, you know what? You know what? I'm just going to leave. And he's lucky Juan isn't whooping his ass right now, man. But Daniel Bryan and Riley Sparks for the Intercontinental Championship. Well, this is a great main event right here. Great! The Intercontinental Championship will be on the line as Riley Sparks takes on Daniel Bryan himself. The Intercontinental Championship on the line. Is this a submission match? I don't know. I hope it was, but Sparks, Bryan, two young superstars. Believe they are the best in that ring, are the best in the world at what they do. Time to show it here on Friday Night SmackDown's main event. And we still got a confrontation between Christian and Shelton Benjamin. They're going to come out here and have a confrontation on the contract about their match at King of the Ring in the steel cage match. So they got to sign that contract that they're both going to a steel cage match and the liability thing, you know, WWE won't be held responsible for any injuries or anything like that. So that's coming up after this match, match for the Intercontinental Championship. Daniel Bryan is making his way out here. And for those of you who didn't see or didn't hear, Daniel Bryan has traded in his chance at a rematch for the Tag Team Championships for this opportunity to have a match for the Intercontinental Championship. Now, I don't know if he's foolish or not, but it's a great surprise, a good way to surprise the champ. I bet you the champ wasn't expecting this at all, but if Daniel Bryan loses this one, he doesn't have anything left to go back to. He goes back to being a singles competitor. And we haven't seen Daniel Bryan as a singles competitor in quite a while. Last time I saw him in a singles match on pay-per-view was at our elimination pay-per-view against CM Punk. And that was one hell of a match, but you know, after that it was like he has to go to tag team wrestling with William Regal. But here we go. Can Daniel Bryan capture the Intercontinental Championship, the Workhorse Championship? Is it going to D-Bry? Or will Riley Sparks have another successful title retain? I hope Daniel Bryan wins this one and becomes the new Intercontinental Champion. But we're about to see what goes on here as D-Bry takes on Riley Sparks. They're walking the ring, just feeling, getting the feel for each other right here. Just getting the feel for each other, just throwing punches, you know, tempting each other. That's how you do it. That's how you start a match. You just get this going right here. And Riley Sparks right now, what's he thinking right here? Look at D-Bry with the beautiful counter. Daniel Bryan now brings the attack, starting an attack. That's how you do it. Slow to start the match, but then Daniel Bryan comes in, punches and flurries to take down Riley. And now the reverse. Look at that, countering one of his punches. And deep, God, Daniel Bryan got caught right there. But Daniel Bryan got the way again. Bryan and Riley Sparks. We're looking for an instant classic here tonight. The Intercontinental Championship is on the line. Main event time here on Friday Night SmackDown, with two of SmackDown's brightest young stars. D-Bry in trouble if Riley Sparks gets into the zone he wants. A power slam by Sparks. Sparks with an elbow, dropping it. That's how you do it. And now as Riley Sparks now is looking to lift up D-Bry, looking to just pick him up and see what he can. Oh, wait. Daniel, we've seen this situation when he goes on the legs like that. But Riley Sparks knows that very well and moves out the way. Going at the legs of Bryan. That's not a bad game plan. Daniel Bryan really uses those legs to get you down to the ground so he can kick your head off. And right now, Riley knows what he's doing at the moment. But I don't think he can handle this guy, man. Hey, this is an Extreme Rules match, apparently. No disqualification, apparently. That's what I'm being told right now, you know. No DQs. Daniel Bryan can smack him with that chair. Riley Sparks can smack him with that chair. They can both smack each other with the chair. Hell, they can smack each other with a duck. That's the beauty of it. And look at Daniel Oh, Daniel faking out. But look at that. Riley was like, "Ooh, you ain't coming out." But Daniel says, "Let me fly like that." The referee saying, "I don't want this in the way." Daniel with the suicide dive. Daniel Bryan. Oh, hell breaking loose for him right now. He's pretty much saying, "I can do whatever I want." Daniel. Wait. It's Steve Bryan. Capture the chair, Riley. That's it. Wait, what the ref? Hey. No, it's another disqualification match. You disqualify. What the f? What? No, this makes no damn sense. This was a no disqualification match, and you just disqualified Daniel Bryan. What the f? Oh, no. Wait, what the f? What is going on here? What's going on Friday nights? That, my friends, is Booker T. We haven't seen him since he's been retired. By Rey Mysterio, Booker T back in the house, back on SmackDown. What's going on, though, is my question. What is going on here? Is he here to help us address the situation that just happened? Please tell me you are. That's a good move right there. Who's the new assistant to the generals? Thank you. Riley does have the refs on the payroll. The ref, a special guest referee, Booker T. The match will be restarted for the Intercontinental Championship. Here we go, Brian. And Riley Sparks, the match being restarted. Booker T's a special guest referee, and Riley Sparks like, what the f? No, I won the match. But no, you don't win the match when you have a referee on the payroll. You don't do that, man. And he won the match because of that. And now look at Daniel, he's like, I'm going to get you. I'm going to beat the holy hell out of you. So here we go, time for SEAM Intercontinental Championship match right here. This is going to be a big one right here. We got Booker T. Oh, look at Riley Sparks going right after Booker T. And Booker's like, don't get me started, sucker. I will lay you out. I think Riley Sparks is trying to get himself disqualified intentionally again. But you know what? This is no disqualification, son. This time I hope it's a real no disqualification match. Hope it's not like the last one where you apparently paid the referee off. And that's why we have Booker T here. Yeah, the ref's on the books, man. He's on the books of Riley Sparks. He's being paid by Sparks. And Sparks runs right into a dropkick by Daniel Bryan. Normally, Daniel Bryan will drop a dropkick on someone. But no, Sparks ran into that one just because he's a fool like that. But D. Bryan, Sparks going at it for the Intercontinental Championship. Again tonight, the previous match was them going for the title again, but the referee kind of screwed Daniel Bryan in a no disqualification match. He disqualified Daniel Bryan, so, oh, Sparks just sending Daniel Bryan flying to my announce table. That's mine. And now here we go. Sparks working on it right here. This is what he does best right now. Now he's taking control of the match again, and this is what he does right here. Just does things like that. Little things that will hurt you. Little things that will hurt the smallest parts of your body. That way you're like, oh, Jesus. Oh, man, this hurts so much. It's okay. It's okay. And now D. Bry in the ring by himself while Sparks has a table. Not the smartest move ever. D. Bry. Oh, D. Bry knocks down Booker. What the f is going on here, man? I don't understand what that was all about, but Booker T is getting knocked down more than... Oh, but look at... Now Sparks like, I can knock him out better than you can, and a neck breaker. And Booker T is like, you know what? I'm going to let that fly, but next time I'm going to lay you suckers out. Booker T being that impartial referee right now, and not a bad place for Booker T to go. But now Sparks going for a DDT right here. Could he connect? He got the DDT. A beautiful move right there by the kid from the Sparks Land. And there it is, bam. The Intercontinental Champion right now in full control. He's been the champion since WrestleMania. He defeated Kofi Kingston in what was probably a match of the night at WrestleMania. Oh, but look at Daniel Bryan able to get out the way. Remember, Daniel Bryan also had some success at that WrestleMania with the flying headbutt. Remember, he captured the tag team championships that night alongside William Regal when they defeated McGillicuddy and Otunga. And look at Daniel Bryan with the submission hold. He's trying to rip the man of a million and thousands and billions and trillions and kajillions submission holds. Daniel Bryan is trying to make the Intercontinental Champion tap out. Then Sparks, oh, getting out of it. Sparks with the knee to the face, the flexibility to be able to do that by Sparks. Good flexibility by this kid. But look at Daniel Bryan, a big time kick knocking down Riley Sparks. That's the way you do it, man. If you're a guy like Sparks, oh, he was going for that kick again, and Sparks, oh, this time he's going like, I know what you did last time. So I'm dropping an elbow on you. You know, Sparks won the title at WrestleMania alongside Daniel Bryan, so they both had a great WrestleMania. But Daniel Bryan won the tag team titles and Sparks won the Intercontinental Championship. You know, they all had their great moments, but now it's the roads have led to this right here, you know, to Daniel Bryan and Riley Sparks going at it. Daniel Bryan giving up his rematch for the tag team championships for a chance to get a chance at the Intercontinental Championship. And remember, Mr. Duncan will return next week to SmackDown. I cannot wait to see it. Duncan, who has been suspended for trying to screw over Riley Sparks at the pay-per-view Redemption, NXT Redemption. You know, he tried to screw him over, and he got suspended for that. But now he's back, and we'll see what he's going to do. But he said Booker T said he is the new assistant general manager, so he will be helping out Mr. Duncan here and with this whole Riley Sparks situation, since Mr. Duncan wants nothing to do with it. And Daniel Bryan says, let me drop you a brain buster, sucker. And there's the pin. Daniel Bryan could be our new Intercontinental Champion. Now kick out by Sparks. Sparks going like, uh-uh, son, I don't lose titles like that. Oh, baby, whenever this title's on the line, man, he never loses. One, two, oh, not even a kick out. Not even a two count, but whenever the title's on the line, he's not lost. He's been very successful with that title. That's something you know, you have to see with the champion. When you're a champion, you always have to be successful. And Sparks is like talking to Booker T, like, yeah, I bet you you're going to try to screw me out of my title, aren't you? Because Rey Mysterio made you retired you. Remember, Rey Mysterio did retire Booker T, and then after the match, when Booker T was about to tell us something huge, which I believe was telling us the identity of who ran over Teddy Long, but now we know it's Rey Mysterio, Riley's World would come out and they lay him out, and Riley Sparks was one of those guys attacking him, so it only makes sense that Booker T comes back here tonight and screws him over, you know? But I don't think Booker's that kind of guy. I think Booker just wants to call it right down the middle and not have any controversy. I think he believes Daniel Bryan can defeat Riley Sparks here tonight and take the Intercontinental Championship away from him. D-Bry with the big time move right there. Daniel Bryan hoping to be a face of... Oh, look at this. Oh, baby. Hoping to be the face of SmackDown here. Hoping to be the hero that SmackDown needs. Hoping to be the guy that can help destroy this old little group called Riley's World. And who doesn't want to see Riley's World just get the hell out of here? Nobody wants to see him here anymore. A big-time boot to Mr. Sparks right now. Daniel Bryan, one of the best wrestlers, in my opinion, in the world. And he's showing us here tonight why with moves like that. Moves like that are why he's pretty good right there. And Deep Rod going high risk. Oh, man, he misses it. He misses it. Sparks just smart enough to know what's going on. He gets a neck breaker on Booker T. And now he's unloading on Booker T. What the? Booker, lay him out with the book bottom. I think he's really trying to get Booker T. And look at that. Oh, there we go. A lapel lock. The lapel lock is on. The lapel lock is on. It's going. Daniel Bryan caught him right when Riley Sparks was not even paying attention. And look at the lapel lock. Sparks about to tap. He's about to tap, tap. Look at the hands. Just like, oh, I'm going to tap. I'm going to tap. And Daniel. Sparks is holding on, though. Daniel. Oh, look at Sparks able to get out of it. Oh, my God, man. How do you get out of that? I got to ask Sparks how he got out of that, because he just got out of the lapel lock, and now he's going back to work on Daniel Bryan. But I thought Daniel was going to be the champion for a couple seconds, right? I was thinking, oh, he's got it. We're going to have a new Intercontinental Champion here tonight. I still believe he's going to beat him, but I now need to know how he's going to beat him. You know, you just hit your finisher on him. You just gave him your best move, and look at the shoulder block by Sparks. Riley Sparks, though, he's going back for that kick again. He does this a lot. It's not a bad move, because you can concuss your opponent with enough kicks to the head. You can concuss him, and the match could be called over. But we'll see if Booker calls it like that here tonight. That Sparks right now is going That kick to the head again. He's really trying to give Daniel Bryan a concussion here. Really trying to stop this match here. He is trying to make this match just stop. And I don't know if he's going to be able to get that. Here we go. Time for a... Oh, wait, look at Daniel right there. Scouting it out. I told you, that's why Daniel Bryan is one of the best in the world. He scouts out his opponent. He's able to do whatever he needs to do. Headbutt an elbow. But look at Sparks. Able to get out of the way. Sparks, time to fly with that frog splash. A frog splash looking for the win. He's won matches before like that. No, kick out by D-Bry. Daniel Bryan with the kick out. Here comes Way Aldo. He might be in trouble here as D-Bry in the house doing what he needs to do. Here we go. Lift him up. Bam, sucker. Wait, what is this? Look at this submission hold. Look at this submission hold. Look at Daniel Bryan. Look at the way he's got himself. Just, oh my God, the shoulder, the pecs, all this shit up. Damn, oh my God, all the upper body part must have hurt it. But look at Raleigh again, able to get out of the submission, finding a way to get out of the submissions. And that's something that's very special when you're able to face Daniel Bryan. Find a way to get out of all of his submissions. And there's an elbow to the back of Daniel Bryan. As we see Riley Sparks right now. A kick to the side of the head again. Again, is he really trying to finish this match by concussion or getting himself disqualified? Even though this is no disqualification match, it's not going to happen. He's lifting him up again, and Daniel Bryan says, I've watched too much tape to see what you can do when you do those things. And look at, oh, Daniel. Oh, there's a shoulder block by Sparks, and now D-Bry says, son, a kick to the side of the head, lays him out. Daniel Bryan going berserks, going bananas, go freak show bananas. D-Bry, the fans are loving it. A knee to the face. The fans, almost all of them are up and out of their seats. Hopefully all of them can get up their fucking seats, you know, but it's okay. Seats are very comfortable. I'm sitting in a seat right now, and there's a big time kick, and now he's going to pick him. Oh, look at that. Sparks might have been busted open, though, by that kick. I think he has been, but... Oh, no. He's got him lifted up. And D-Bry again says, no. He keeps trying to go for that Sparks. He's going to try to go for the Sparks clash. It's not working, though. It's not working. You know, he calls it the Sparks clash because AJ Styles called it the Sparks clash. Styles called it the Styles clash. And he's going to call it the Sparks Clash. I don't understand this, but they are part of the same little group. And look at Riley Sparks right now, just going right after the leg of him. But look at this. D-Bry might be thinking, it's time to take control of what was once mine and go back for those kicks again. Oh, he's way where is D-Bry going? Oh, my God, D-Bry. Is he going for a superplex? Oh, Jesus. Oh, the impact on the backs. Daniel Bryan. Oh, baby. Daniel Bryan will be our new Intercontinental Champion. No. But Sparks right now is in trouble. Daniel Bryan is giving him everything he's got. There's that kick to the side of the head. Daniel Bryan is doing everything. Here we go. It's time for a lapel lock. It's over. No way Sparks can reach the ropes. No way. And Booker's like, come on. Tap out. And oh, Sparks able to reach the rope on that. But no, he got him this time. Oh, no. No, not like this. No. Sparks clash. It's over. Riley Sparks. Oh, wait, a reversal. A reverse by D-Bry. D-Bry. Oh, kick out by Sparks. I thought Daniel had him there. And Daniel's in disbelief right now. But look at Sparks out of nowhere with that neck breaker. Wow, that right there was that could have been something right there. That could have been something big right there. We could have seen Daniel Bryan cap his night off as the Intercontinental Champion. But look at Sparks trying to kill him here. Another attack to the head. Reach in of Daniel, but Daniel is out. Daniel could be out like no, not even a two count. Daniel's trying to show to Sparks, this is what I can do. I'm not a weak link. I can knock you out anytime I want. Where's he going? He's grabbing a table. This might not be the smartest idea, but... Oh, wait, where's Sparks going? What's going on here? Are they grabbing weapons? As Riley Sparks is down over there. And Daniel Bryan, where's Sparks going? Sparks going high risk, but look at Daniel. He goes like... Shouldn't have taken that much time. And look at him knocking him out of the ring. What a fall. And Daniel. Daniel Bryan just flew. And something happened with him. I don't know. He must have felt worse than Sparks. Yeah, that was a glitch. Yeah, and D-Bry now working on Sparks. The fans want to see, they want to see D-Bry put him through that barrier, but I don't think D-Bry is big enough to do that. Daniel Bryan tossing the ladder in the ring. Where? What is Sparks thinking right now? He's grabbing his championship. What's he doing with his title? And Daniel Bryan's just looking at him like, hey, look at Daniel Florino! Out of nowhere! Out of nowhere! I think Sparks was thinking, fuck it, it's time to leave the match. I'm just going to walk out with my title and there's nothing they can do about it. That's usually what you do when you're a champion, just walk out like that. And look at Daniel strike. I think Daniel might have a concussion. He's striking the wrong things right now. And Sparks got it. Oh, no, no. Look at this shaving. Oh, come on, man. Look at that. Riley Sparks just using the belt as a weapon right now against. And just throwing at a D-Bry. Yeah, it's the Intercontinental Championship. That's the title you care most about. You're just doing it like that. Come on, man. Sparks right now grabbing a ladder. He's got the ladder. I'm thinking, what is he doing now? He's got a table. Oh, he's got... Oh, no, no, no. I think I know what's going to happen here. Oh, my God. No, 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 no. Brian, get up. Booker, stop this. Book T. Big T. Stop this, man. Stop this. He's about to fly onto that table and knock down Brian. He's flying. Oh, look at Daniel Bryan able to get out the way. And Riley Sparks could be in trouble because now Daniel's looking to climb that ladder. Punch, another punch, just trading punches right now, trading uppercuts on the top of the ladder, and now Sparks, oh, no, don't drop him, oh, he just dropped him off the ladder, and Sparks, high risk, frog splash all the way from the ladder, 1, 2, kick out by Brian, a kick out by Brian, how did he do that, look at Riley Sparks, I'm mad at the officiating of Booker T, trying to strike him, and Daniel's is watching this, and look at Booker, he's like, get me away from the sucker before I lay him out, and there it is, LaBelle Lock, you should have been paying attention, son, another LaBelle Lock is hooked, there's no way in hell you're kicking out of this one, no way, no, you're not kicking out of this one, Riley Sparks, no, oh, he's gotten out of it, my God, how does he do this, a shoulder block by Sparks, and Daniel Bryan now, a kick to the side of the head of Sparks, and Daniel setting up the table again, I don't know why, but you can see now Sparks taking advantage of that, now Daniel's going like, I'll strike you with everything, I got a kick to the side of the head, but he's got a ladder, he's got the ladder, I'm trying to figure out what D-Bry's thinking right now. And Daniel Bryan with a nice Russian leg sweep on Riley Sparks. And he's got the table again. What is he thinking here with these tables, man? I think he's waiting for Sparks to get up so he can give him a good chair shot. And there it is, the good chair shot. Nah, I'm just kidding. The good table shot. As D-Bry now wants to climb the ladder. He might be thinking headbutt. Headbutt off the ladder to the table where Sparks is at. Here we go. It's time to fly, D-Bry. Headbutt off the ladder. D-Bryan. Bryan's the new champion. No. No. And now, oh my God. No. A Sparks clash on the ladder. Oh my God. On the pieces of the broken table. Booker T's counting. And kick out by D-Bry. Oh my goodness gracious. What is it going to take to knock out the other guy? Daniel Bryan with an impressive flying headbutt. And then Riley Sparks able to get back into the match with that Sparks clash on the broken ashes of the table. Sparks and Bryan fighting for the Intercontinental Championship here tonight on the main event of Friday Night SmackDown. And remember, folks, we still have one more thing after this. The contract signing between Christian and Shelton Benjamin for their match at King of the Ring. And they're trading punches. Here we go with big kick. D-Bry, a big punch. Oh, my God. No. Suplex. Suplex. Both men. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That is wickedly crazy right there. Wickedly crazy. Oh my God, man. I don't know what... these two men are just destroying each other for the Intercontinental Championship. Riley. Side to the kick. A big time kick to the side of the head. Daniel Bryan might have suffered a concussion from this match. And there's the Sparks clash. This has got to be it, man. That's it. It's over. Daniel Bryan is done. 2, 3. It's over. Sparks wins. You know, seeing both men just falling off the ladder to the outside, you knew it was the end. And then Sparks just capitalizes and puts that kick to the side of the head on Bryan, and then lands the Styles Clash. The Sparks Clash. He lands it and he takes him out. Kind of knew all that was just coming right here. Right here, where it shows the moment right here. Falling off the top of the ladder all the way to the ring, that's at least 20 feet. And then right there, hit the Styles Clash for the pin, and Booker T's like, damn it. But we knew. Just after that fall, whoever was able to get the up first and take advantage of it, they would win, and Sparks did that. Sparks is still the Intercontinental Champion. And now Daniel Bryan, I don't know where Daniel Bryan goes from here. I hope Booker T gives him another chance. You know, Booker T tells him, you know what? After all this bullshit, maybe you can still get a chance at the titles, the tag team titles. You know, after all the bullshit that Sparks just did, this was just going to be, you know, forget it. You didn't put your opportunity on the line against Sparks. Who knows? But where does Bryan go from here? And fucking Riley Sparks. Stay tuned. We got a contract signing coming up. Here comes the captain of charisma, Christian. And Sparks like, hey, I'm not even going. What the? Oh, no, that's Swagger. What is that's Rhodes? What are Swagger and Rhodes doing here? The All-American Dreams. What are they doing? Attacking the captain of charisma. I bet you Shelton Benjamin had this planned out. Bet you Shelton and Charlie Haas had this planned out for him. And throw him right onto the stage. Oh my God. This is just sick. It's just sick, man. And here comes Shelton Benjamin up for the contract signing. My God. What the f? That's Charlie Haas. What the f? Oh, he just let him. What the f? Oh, my God.